Select samples to analyze and click the Create Series button. Select a preset normalize scenario for the RNA-Seq data sets. There is no flag in the RNA-Seq data, so remain the flag set as blank. When the series is loaded, Analysis Browser opens. The series panel appears at left. In the Setup Series tab in the lower panel, click the Edit Parameters button. Edit the parameter table. Keep one kind of information in one column. Fill all column titles. Set as numerical type for columns with only numbers. You can bring information from sample information if you like. Save and exit. Switch to the Setup Dataset tab. Change the order of parameters. Check the boxes of parameters to use and clear if you don't. Set separate groups and color block options for each parameter. Clear ID and rep and create a new dataset as average. You see the saved datasets in the series panel. Select one to show. You can mask any sample groups from a dataset if you like. Double-click on an axis of the chart to edit scale settings. Giving fixed max and min values makes the drawing faster. Switch to CH1 raw signal and optimize the scale in the same way. The scale setting affects all other viewers like scatter plot. In the scatter plot view, you can assign a sample to an axis by drag and drop. You can select genes by dragging on the graph area and see how they behave in other samples. You can compare averages of sample groups under the average dataset as well. This operation of the scatter plot view is fundamental to understand the data correctly. It is a good idea to make a note in the sample info tab. Copy information from the geo record and paste in the notes field. Edit the content to make it readable. Download a PDF of the paper, and attach it so that you can read it anytime. And keep the URL in notes so that you can open it quickly. You go to learn about normalization next.